This is a presentation on contact lens-related complications. Contact lenses are used for both optical and therapeutic purposes. Although contact lens use is generally safe, complications may still arise due to lens or patient-related factors. Corneal complications include microbial keratitis, corneal neovascularization, epitheliopathy, edema. Ocular surface complications include dry eye syndrome, conjunctivitis, and lens-related problems include spoilage, splitting, lost lens, corneal warpage, and ptosis. Microbial keratitis is the most feared complication of contact lens use. It needs to be excluded in a contact lens wearer with a painful red eye. Risk factors include poor contact lens hygiene or habits, extended wear, soft contact lens. The infection is usually a gram-negative bacterial infection, and the treatment for infective keratitis is covered under a separate lecture. Epitheliopathy is due to mechanical trauma with micro or macro abrasions. It can also be due to toxicity associated with cleaning solutions or corneal hypoxia from tight-fitting lens or prolonged use. Management includes avoidance of lenswear, topical lubricants, prophylactic topical antibiotics, and finally, re-evaluation of the fit of the contact lens. Contact lens wear induces a variable amount of hypoxia, and this depends on the oxygen transmissibility of the lens and the patient's susceptibility. And corneal edema may be epithelial or even stromal edema. Corneal neovascularization is a result of chronic corneal hypoxia. It is common with soft contact lens use and most pronounced superiorly. It can be divided into superficial or deep neovascularization. In deep neovascularization, there is a risk of vascular ingrowth involving visual axis, lipid exudation, and scarring. The management of corneal neovascularization includes reduction of lens wear, evaluation of lens fit, or stopping the lens wear completely, especially with deep vascularization. Allergic conjunctivitis is due to an allergy to thimerosal, a preservative in contact lens solutions. Indeed, the solution is the problem. There is papillary conjunctivitis with redness, itch, and burning sensation. The treatment involves stopping contact lens use temporarily, topical antihistamine or mast cell stabilizers, switching to alternative solutions, or daily disposable lens. Giant papillary conjunctivitis results from mechanical trauma of lens on superior tarsal conjunctiva and hypersensitivity response to allergens on the lens surface. Symptoms include contact lens intolerance, itch, discharge, redness, and fluctuating vision. Each giant papillary is more than 0.3 millimeters in size. There's conjunctival injection and lens coating. Treatment for giant papillary conjunctivitis includes a contact lens break, switching to disposable or rigid lenses, and topical antihistamine or mast cell stabilizers. Other complications include lost lens, corneal warpage, or aponeurotic ptosis. Prevention of contact lens-related complications involves first avoiding corneal injury. The contact lens user should ideally be free of ocular surface disease, capable of good contact lens hygiene and compliance. Lens use should be daily wear rather than extended wear, and regular examination for complications and timely replacement of lens if spoilage is detected should be performed. Secondly, contact lens contamination should be minimized. There should be compliance with lens hygiene. Cleaning solutions should be sterile. And the user should use a clean storage case with right and left lens kept separately. The case should be emptied, washed, and disinfected after each use and regularly replaced. Thank you.